Welcome to Football Analysis. Bold as in, you understand, and of course I try to be as bold and straightforward as possible. Having said that, while I'm here in the bubble of the ISL, Indian Super League, I am trying to contribute from my side and try to use my time as good as possible, and I will do some analysis on certain games. I will not choose every game, but to try to pick some games that would be interesting to analyze. I cannot use any video material, therefore I will use animations, and I will only look into key moments in the game. Also, I want to try to keep it as short as possible and to be as objective as possible. So I'm not going to fill in the way I would, how I would find solutions or do things. Of course, I will here and there give some ideas on how I would do it, but at the same time I try to just to be as objective as possible, and hopefully as a supporter or anyone who's watching can do his benefit with it. Let's dive right into the analysis, and hopefully you enjoy. Cheers. Mumbai City versus SC East Bengal. I was really looking forward to this game. It was a pretty exciting game, but in the end, the praise that Mumbai got was, in my opinion, too much, because I think it was more due to lack of quality mistakes of East Bengal. And let's get right into it. Mumbai City lined up in a 4-2-3-1, same as the last game. Of course, Jahu came back into the game. Mandar, who's normally a left back, or he is a left winger, but he was placed forward in the left wing position. And on the left side, a difficult name for me, Dakshinan. Forgive me for the name. He came inside. And on the right side, Bipin came inside. I pointed out the last game that Mumbai had problems on the wings, so that issue was addressed. And from the midfield, Herman, he was from the midfield put back into the defense, same like the first game. Now, having all said that, it was not very convincing to me the first game. They lost Mumbai City. The second game, they were lucky to get a penalty. And this game, I also think it was more due to problems that East Bengal had. Doesn't mean that they didn't deserve to win, but it was not convincing to me at all the way they played. It was more due to certain errors of Sport Club East Bengal. And let's dive into that in a bit. Rakib also came inside on the right back, so there were a few changes there. Sport Club East Bengal started the first game in a 3-4-3 formation, but this game they changed it back to a 4-2-3-1. Now, if you look into the issues in the game, that is important. From the first minute, the first 2 minutes, whatever, Fox got an injury, the captain. That was a big blow for Sport Club East Bengal. So one of your foreigners, your leaders, that led to right away discussion. What are we going to do? What is the lineup going to be, the substitution? And that was, in my opinion, the key point of this game. Neville, who normally played the right back, and up front Singh, who is the right winger, they switched positions. That means Neville came to the right center back and Singh came to the right back position. The right back position here was key. This was the whole tactical issue for me that Mumbai won their game. And scoreboard analysis to say 3-0 win and everything is great. I mean, you still have to win. You still have to put the ball into the net. But sometimes you have moments in a game that are hugely influential to the rest of the game or the outcome of the game. And that was, in my opinion, the right back position. Now, in the beginning, Sport Club East Bengal started in a 4-4-2 after that substitution, but they changed later back again to a 4-2-3-1. I don't know exactly which minute. The 1-0, as I said, Suchandra Singh was the key element here. A right winger who was right back
during the game. And I don't know if there's on the bench a player who could play this position on the right back, because I will point out what I think went wrong here. There was a corner for East Bengal. From this ball, it came to Bipin, who protected the ball, dropped it off later. But what you can see here is that Nbomos is still here, and also Lefondre is still here. This is key, by the way, especially see where Lefondre is. And East Bengal players still have the opportunity to track back. Now, this ball ends up with Burgess. Burgess is, I will always refer to my protege. I really, really am a big fan of Burgess. And he played a fantastic pass, one touch forward. And of course, this is pure quality. And that ball ended up front. Again, watch here where Lefondre is. The ball gets now here with Bumos. And this is the key point. This is a 50-50 ball. And because I think when you are a defender, the first thing you do is shoulder to shoulder, and you go shielding the ball. You push the player off the ball and you protect the ball instead of trying to reach for the ball and getting outplayed. This is a typical, how would I say that? He's an attacker, he's not a defender, a huge mistake. So this is a crucial moment where I say defensively very poor. And if I think if the right back, if a proper right back would be there, this would not have happened. Does that mean that Mumbai would not have won? That I'm not saying. But this is a crucial moment because it kills further your confidence. You just lost your center back. And then this easy, you give away the ball. So he tries to go for the ball while he should have pushed a shoulder push and shield the ball. And from that, of course, you can see here Lefondre showing up in the box, while I showed you before they should have marked back, track back much better. Then we go to the second half. The game is not done. The game is still open, 1-0 only. Then you start the game in the first minute of the second half. Here again, the right back, Susandra Singh, makes a throw-in. Very easy to anticipate from Mumbai. They catch the ball and somehow the ball goes forward and they lose the ball again. And this is what I'm talking about. When you start a game, you need to build confidence. Giving that ball away so easy is never a good start. We move on from this moment. Mumbai gets a throw-in. They start building up and the ball goes to the other side. East Bengal gets the ball back again. So this is all within a time span of 2 minutes. And here you see where the left center back plays the ball to the other side. Again, to Susandra Singh. It's not a good pass. And he decides to play one touch forward and starts running forward. That is his attacking mindset. Very risky, because what you do is, if that ball in this short distance, if you lose the ball, you open up that space. At the same time, Neville is coming to support. But at the same time, Susandra Singh plays one touch. While if this ball is played, this ball right away, the first thing that needs to happen is both striker Bumos and Lefondre need to be marked forward by the defense of East Bengal. I call that the rest defense. You don't stay open. You have to already start thinking defensively. So what happens? The 1-2 is set up. Susandra Singh is going forward, and keep in mind here where I say here the left center back of East Bengal, I think it's Ishat, if I'm correct, he should think defensively. He should already start marking forward, because as I said, I called it the rest defense. If you stay open and you lose the ball, you get right away that counterattack. We get again a situation where Susandra is a little bit naive. He gets pushed off the ball. Where I say block it, use your body. One of the most interesting things where I say Indian players need to learn, learning how to protect the ball. Don't be too naive. You can still play that ball after. First protect it with your body. The ball goes into the midfield, and either you have a good coach, a bad coach on your team. This ball you should not give to Jahu. He will play that one touch. He right away in one split vision sees that opening, but I go back again. The the situation where I pointed out where here the player defender should have marked into Bomos, and then you get the counter attack because they are too open, and you get into the penalty situation. You see it here more from the back, where I speak about, see the number 66. Again, this is Ishrat, who before that, when the ball is on the wing, on the side, should already have marked Bomos closer, because that's good defending. He should have been, you don't have to be on top of him, but within a reach of 3-4 meters. That means that you right away can react. But if you're too far away and you're just watching the ball, yeah, then you get these moments. And both center backs are now surprised. Neville, who went to the side to support, but then, yeah, the ball by Susandra Cink was one touch forward. So you're both open, both center backs, and in the counter you get exposed. This is the key. These are the key two things: the right back position, making mistakes, to 2-0. The 3-0 is not important to me anymore. I already knew they were going to lose. So, congratulations to Mumbai. It was not convincing. Even if you see a 3-0, it was not based on fantastic play. Yes, they had a lot of ball possession. But in my opinion, the key element here is East Bengal losing their centre back, putting a right winger on the right back position. And I hope, or I question, or I wonder if they had another option there. If not, yeah, then you have to deal with that situation. But that did not get the result they wanted. Also, physically, I think East Bengal the second half is not able to play the game in a higher intensity, and that, yeah, we can't blame them because of the start of the season was late, etc., etc. So a lot of job, a lot of work to do for East Bengal. Mumbai will gain confidence from that, but still not convincing to me.